Well, thank you, Mr. Chairman, members of the committee, for the opportunity to speak with you today. My name is Matt Ellenwood, and I'm the director of the North Carolina Justice Center's Education and Law Project, where we represent and advocate on behalf of low-income children across North Carolina. We hope that this year's budget will focus on improving teacher compensation, recruitment, and retention, as others have mentioned, but we also hope that it will restore funding that impacts the classroom. We believe it's vital to prioritize an increase in funding that impacts children directly over changes to policies that would reduce the amount of revenue available to, the amount of revenue available to fund these key educational needs. And as a lot of the other speakers have said, this is really a critical moment for North Carolina's teachers. North Carolina currently ranks 42nd among states in average teacher pay. Teacher pay has dropped by 13.5% when adjusting for inflation since 1999. In 2014-15, the teacher turnover rate was almost 15%. As others have mentioned, the enrollments in the teacher education programs have declined dramatically. We currently rank 10th amongst the 12 states in the Southeast region in terms of average teacher pay. If teachers were given a 5% raise each year going forward, it would still take 10 years to reach the national average. Whereas if they were given a 10% raise each year, it would take about 3 years, and there's an urgency to the situation now. Since it's going to take a concerted effort to move North Carolina's teacher compensation to the national average, we believe that's the highest priority right now. But teacher classroom conditions are just as important to recruiting and retaining teachers as teacher pay. That's something we hear from teachers all the time, that it's just becoming much more difficult to do their job, and that's what's driving a lot of these declines and retention problems. Since the beginning of the recession in 2008, funding for teachers and teaching assistants has declined by about $60 million. Funding for textbooks and instructional supplies is about half of what it was. Funding professional development, literacy coaches, and teacher mentoring has been eliminated entirely. We believe that funding for program professional materials should be prioritized over new and experimental programs like achievement school districts or further expansion of the voucher program prior to having meaningful data about how the program is operating. Again, improving teacher compensation and restoring funding to the classroom will improve teacher recruitment, help retain degree teachers as we do have, improve educational outcomes for children. So we hope that these will be given the highest priority on the side of the phone. Thank you very much for your consideration.